Discus Group are here for all your CD, DVD, Blu-ray and printing needs. To begin with, we check your artwork supplied to ensure it will obtain good print results. We can now output the design to aluminium plates, making one per colour used within the design. The plate setter uses thermofuse technology to expose the image onto an aluminium plate. The negative aluminium plate is then placed into the plate setter to be exposed, creating an image of your artwork onto the coating of the printing plate. The plate setter also applies a bent edge so it can be clamped by the printing press. Each plate is then manually fed into each printing press bay, ready for printing. The operator firmly attaches the plate to the plate cylinder. The operator sets up the print job and the paper is fed into one end of the Heidelberg Speedmaster printing press. Each piece of paper passes through each printing bay, which applies one of the CMYK colours. The ink is transferred from the ink reservoirs onto the printing plate on the plate cylinder. Once all bays have printed each colour, the printer removes one sheet for testing. A pure white light is used to visually check the print for imperfections. The print technician then uses a densitometer to check the density makeup of each colour. This ensures that the correct amount of ink is used and the colours are correctly balanced. Once the job is printed, the flat sheets are placed into a Heidelberg cylinder for die cutting. Individual sheets are fed into the Heidelberg cylinder by suction cups, which guide the sheet down to the cylinder. Each sheet is then fed through between the Heidelberg cylinder and the die, where pressure is applied to make the required cuts and creases. The cylinder operator removes a sample to ensure the alignment is correct and all the edges meet once folded up. Once this quality control is passed, the stacked print is passed onto the guillotine. This removes the remaining edges to be cut off that the Heidelberg cylinder cannot trim. The cylinder operator then removes the unwanted excess paper, which is sent for recycling. The wallets are then stacked up, ready for gluing. Each stack is then placed into the mole pocket folder input hopper. The wallets are then fed via rollers down the conveyor belt. Here you can see the section which folds over the gluing flaps as each wallet passes through. A series of dots of glue are placed on the folded flap. The whole wallet is then folded in half, gluing one side to the other. The glued wallet is then passed through a weighted wheel, firmly pressing the two sides together. The glued wallets are collected up and samples are quality checked to ensure they meet the required standards before being transferred onto the Velcro application line. The wallets are placed into the input hopper of the Velcro application line. Each card wallet then passes down the conveyor belt. This is where the rubber roller applies two precisely located Velcro tabs. The complete finished product then collects in an output hopper at the end of the line, ready for boxing. The finished wallet is then thoroughly checked to ensure the Velcro tabs align properly. The completed wallets are then stacked and placed into a box for shipping. Tape is applied to seal the carton before being placed on a pallet, ready for shipping.